Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team fucking here. I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month, nigga. I was trying to get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way home.
All right, welcome to Crack the Collection. This is your boy, Point Forwards Alex. And just like the song says, started from the bottom, now we here. It's baseball season. Orioles gonna be in full effect this year, just like last year. No more surprises, we're not running up on anybody now. The whole league has been put on notice that we're ready to play some baseball in Baltimore. Growing up, I was a big Orioles fan. There wasn't a National League team in the area like there is now with the Washington Nationals. I grew up on AL baseball. I love my Orioles, and I wanted to do a baseball edition of Cracking the Collection. Well, I'll do a couple of them, but the first one is going to represent my Orioles. And if you guys follow me on Instagram or Facebook under Point Forwards Crew on Facebook, or just Point Forwards on Instagram, you'll see that every once in a while I'll post some Orioles stuff and it represents the orange and black. Today I'm going to show two jerseys. Both of them are authentics. One is from the new school and one is from the old school. And I'll start with the new school first. This jersey I picked up at the beginning of last year, and it's a cool base, Matt Wieters. It's got the big Orioles patch on the sleeve. On the front is a double stitch with that beautiful bright orange with the black outline. It's got the 32 on the front, double stitch of course, and then the heat pressed jock tag. Size 48, and then your cool base tag on the side. On the back, you got your big MLB logo right there. Wieters and that big 32. This jersey is made out of that new material, that new cool base material, and it feels great in the summertime when you're at the game and it's 100 degrees, especially, you know, during those day games. The jersey, you know, it's breathable. And it allows for you not to just to be a little more cool out there. Now they have the cool base technology with the hats, and I need to pick one of those up where supposedly it reflects the sun, so we'll see how that works. But check out my boy Hometown Fitted's video on fakes. He breaks down how you know you have authentic jersey. I got this from MLB.com. So I know that's authentic, but there are a lot of fakes out there, so watch out for that. The old school jerseys used to, instead of it being orange across the chest, it was black with the orange outline. But I think the orange leathering just pops a lot more, and it's a hot jersey, and also it's from my favorite team. Next jersey I'm going to show you is from the old school. This right here is my 2001 Cal Ripken Majestic jersey. Now this one right here has a little bit of differences. First of all, it has the old Oriole on the side, on the arm right there. And this one also has the 100 year American League gold patch, which is awesome and very detailed. On the front, just like the new school, we've got Orioles, double stitched across, black outline with the orange, and then you know who number 8 is, that's Cal Ripken. And at the bottom here, we've got our authentic Majestic tagging, and this one also is a size 48. On the back, you got your 2001 American flag And then, of course, Ripken double stitch, and then the big number 8. They've made changes, quite a few changes to this jersey now. Of course, they have the huge Baltimore Orioles patch on the side, which I showed you on the newer style jersey. Also, on the gray aways now, it says Baltimore as opposed to Orioles. And I think that was they made that change when the Nationals came into the D.C. area, because back then the Orioles was all of Maryland, all of D.C., and all of Northern Virginia's team. But when the DMV got their own team, then the Orioles pretty much started representing Baltimore a little heavier, which I can respect that. But they know that they still have some hardcore fans in our area here. So, again, this is one of my favorite jerseys, especially because of the 2011, the 9/11 patch right there, and then, the 2001, not 2011, American League patch. So this year, I can't wait to get out to some Orioles games. I purchased a few tickets already. It was a little easier last year to grab great seats, but now that everyone knows how good the Orioles are, the seats are a little harder to get, but I'm still going to make my way out there to Camden Yards and check out my O's. And I also plan to pick up a new jersey. I'm probably going to pick up an orange one, and I think that one's going to be a J.J. Hardy this year. You see a lot of Adam Jones jerseys, a lot of Markakis, a lot of some Matt Wieters, but J.J. doesn't get a lot of stadium love, so I might pick that up, or I might get a Manny Machado too. So we'll see what selection they have out at the yard and online, and I'm sure I'll make a video to show my new pickup. Thanks again for watching. I hope you enjoy the few pictures that I put up of my Orioles experiences. I cannot wait for the season to start. Be on the lookout for my next MLB video that'll show some of the other things that I have from other teams. And take me out to the ball game. This is your boy, Point Forwards Alex, and can't wait to see you guys at the ballpark. Peace. Just as a reminder to myself, I wear every single chain, even when I'm in the house, cause we started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here, nigga. We don't like to do too much explaining.